Thank you for tuning in to the UC San Diego Mi Camino Student Series, where we'll be taking a look at the diverse journeys of Latinx and Chicanx students as they tell us how they made their way to and through college. Today we're talking with Natalia Avina-Ochoa, a molecular and cell biology major who has participated in important community outreach with a club she started herself and has done some interesting research during her time at UCSD. Thank you for being here, Natalia.
Thank you.
So to start off, I want to ask you a bit about your family. So where are your parents from and what was it like growing up?
So I was born and raised in Mexico. I'm an only child and also a first generation college student. Even though my parents completed some college in Mexico, I think that I didn't have like a lot of help coming from them with the college application process. I also started in community college and I transferred to UC San Diego in the fall of 2019. And that's pretty much it.
So what was your family's philosophy on college going?
My parents, they always told me that I should do whatever made me happy. Like if I like art, I could like study art. If I like it science, I could do science. You know, just pretty much do whatever makes you happy.
That's awesome. So what was your high school experience like? Did you always know you wanted to go into STEM?
I didn't know. In fact, I was debating between culinary school and biology. But I think that as I took more biology classes, I started to realize, okay, like I really want to do this. I want to get into research. This is like really interesting. And I really see myself pursuing a career as a researcher.
So you talked about going to community college. So what was it like going into community college?
Community college was a really interesting experience for me because it allowed me to meet people from like different ages, different backgrounds. But I also got the opportunity to take biology classes, chemistry classes that made me realize that I wanted to major in biology.
So what was it like when you started your first year of college at UCSD?
It was scary at first, especially getting into my first lecture because there were like 300 people in my class. But it was also really exciting because, I was attending my dream school because ever since I was in high school, I knew I wanted to go to UCSD. So it was really cool and exciting.
So what would you say is the main difference between community college versus a college like UCSD that's a four-year institution?
I guess the biggest difference is the class size. Back when I was in community college, there were only like 30 people in my class. UCSD classes are much bigger. And also one of the things that I really like about UCSD are the research opportunities. In community college, I didn't have that. So as soon as I transferred to UCSD, I started doing research, reaching out to research labs. And I also came across a lot of opportunities to learn more about grad school and also getting involved with like-minded people who also wanted to do research.
So speaking of, you know, getting to know people, how did you find community at UCSD?
So I met other transfer students. I also got to meet some people through different clubs or events and also in my classes.
So I know that you started your own club. So what was that like? What was the process of starting your club like? And like, what was it like trying to find new members? That sort of thing.
So I think that starting a new club is really fun because you have to like, first of all, decide what you want to do. You also have to create a logo. And one of the nicest things about UCSD is that they allow you to create your own club if you like fulfill the requirements. In fact, it's really fun because there's like a club for like anything. There's like cooking clubs or like drawing clubs. So there's like something for like basically anyone. And I found it really exciting. Also, you know, trying to get other officers and members and stuff. It was a bit challenging since I started during the pandemic, but I guess that didn't stop me from wanting to start a club. I just had to use other resources such as social media or flyers to spread the word and get members.
So can you talk a bit about what your club does?
So I started Transfer Link. That club, I decided to start it since back when I was in community college, I noticed that most of the students don't really know what the college application process is like. So what we do in this club is that we do workshops in which we explain the college application process or how to like work on your personal statement. But also some of the students that attend our workshops, they have like a lot of questions, mostly because they're like first generation students. So do you want to know what it's like to go to like a 4-year institution? If you have like any recommendations or like where to, how to find a roommate or where to park. So it's really fun because you get to meet like a lot of people. In fact, we had a workshop a couple months ago and there was a guy from San Francisco. So it was really exciting because, you know, we started this club in San Diego and like somehow through social media, someone in San Francisco found out of our club. So
that's really exciting. So could you talk a bit more in depth about other clubs that you've participated in, other groups?
So I was a commuter student. And that's one of the reasons why I decided to join M3C, which is New York Commuter Council. It allowed me to meet other commuter students, and it's really cool because I feel like sometimes it's challenging to have a sense of community as a commuter student. But you get to meet other commuters. They also like give you some tips on like how to pack your lunch, how to like find parking and stuff like that. Besides that, I'm also a mentor at BSSA, which is a Biological Sciences Student Association. And I found that really rewarding because it has allowed me to like meet first year students and provide them with like guidance and some things that I wish I had known back when I started college.
So I wanted to ask if you've had any mentors during your time at UCSD.
Yeah, I had two mentors and I met them as part of my research experience. I guess that it's really scary to get into research, especially when like no one in your family, oh, it's like in the STEM field or anything like that. Because when I first started research, I didn't even know what a publication was. Like I didn't know what a paper was. And yeah, I guess that they have guided me to the process and I have gotten a lot of support from them.
So I want to know how you went about getting mentors. Is that something where like you went into research first and then connected with mentors? Did you find a mentor first and then they introduced you to research? Because I know it can be hard for people to find a mentor at UCSD because it can be intimidating. You were talking about how like there's these classes of 300 people. How do you talk to your professor when there's 299 other people for them to worry about? So how did you come into contact with these mentors?
So my first mentor, during the summer, like right before transferring to UCSD, I applied to the Summer Training Academy for Research Success, which is STARS. It's a program that is funded by UC San Diego. They basically connect you with a mentor and with a research lab, and throughout the summer, you get paid for doing research. And that's the way I met my first mentor. For my second mentor, I wanted to do something different in the terms of research. And this case, I switched from biotechnology to cancer biology / immunology. So yeah, I just emailed a PI and they connected me with a mentor because we had similar like research interests.
Cool. So you talked a bit about your research. I'd like you to go a bit in depth and talk about like what you researched, what you've done. Have you published any papers, anything like that?
So during my junior year, I did biotechnology research. I genetically modify algae to express proteins of interest. And during my senior year, I decided to pursue a different type of research. In this case, I started doing more immunology / cancer biology. And yeah, in fact, I work in a publication that should come out in the next few months. It's a review in immune metabolism. And additionally, I have also got the chance to present at different undergraduate research conferences.
Could you talk a bit about what it's like to present at a conference, how you came upon that opportunity, that sort of thing?
I found a conference through the AAP, which is the Academic Enrichment Programs. They send like a newsletter every month. And that's how I found out about those conferences. It was really intimidating at first because, you know, you're speaking like in a big audience, and also there are like PIs from like different labs and they ask you questions, which can be a little bit intimidating. But I really liked the opportunity to get to know other undergraduates who were also doing research.
That's really interesting. So I wanted to ask really quickly, what sort of advice would you have for scholars that are going into college? Is there anything you've learned over these last few years that you think would be helpful for other people to know?
Yeah, I guess it's get out of your comfort zone. In my case, it took me like my whole junior year to understand that it was really important. But once that I decided to like really get out of my comfort zone, like the best things started to happen to me. You know, I got into a research lab, I got into a master's program. I published a review. I also got to present at a national research conference. So definitely don't be afraid to step out of your comfort zone, because like the best things happen when you do it.
I think that's really good advice. So what are some of your fondest memories at UCSD?
Yeah, it's a really hard question, but I think that one of my best memories is just getting into my first research lab. Growing up and also in high school, I didn't have the opportunity to do research. So most of my love for biology developed just from like reading textbooks or, you know, watching people do experiments, but also like getting the chance to like go to a research lab, do my own experiments and be like, wow, like I'm actually like discovering something, was one of the greatest things that, you know, has happened to me. And also just like getting to know people, like that sense of community, of meeting other people who are also interested in biology and research and who are always like supporting you. I think that's one of like the greatest things that I experienced during my time at UC San Diego.
That's awesome. So just to close out, you did mention that you got into a master's program. So what are your plans after UCSD involving that?
So I'm going to start a master's program at UC San Diego this fall. So I basically get to continue with my research, but in the long term, I hope to like pursue a PhD and continue doing research. And I also want to continue, you know, helping others get involved with research or with the college application process, because I think it's really important to give back to the community.
Absolutely. I mean, just from what I've heard, you sound like you've already been giving back so much to the community. And it's really exciting to think that in the future, you could be that mentor for other people that you have had during your time at UCSD. Anything else you want to say?
Get out of your comfort zone. Like, that's when, like, the best things happen. And never be afraid.
I totally agree. So thank you.
Thank you.